In this lecture, we will look into certain variants of Turing machine. You see, when we have discussed in case of deterministic finite automaton, there also we have looked at certain variants and which motivates you to a Turing machine. Particularly, you know, we have talked about two-way Turing machine, two-way finite automata, and then Moore Mealy type of machines, which essentially having certain features of the Turing machine, that's how we have discussed certain variants there. Here, the variants of Turing machine what we are going to discuss is essentially some sort of extensions and having certain features which you can use in various places to to construct Turing machines very easily using those features. Among which, I will now state few of them, that is two-way infinite tape, Turing machine with K-tape Turing machine, and you know, there are certain others like something like two-dimensional etcetera, okay. And something which is very important is non-deterministic. Now, let me explain what are all these variants of this Turing machines, what kind of extensions are there. Now, you see, when we are working on a standard Turing machine, we have left justified, right side infinite tape. Now, whenever we are working, you know, our working nature is starting from here and we keep on checking whether the symbols, and depending on the type of input what we are receiving, we are always keeping, of course, as a special symbol this blank always at the left end, or depending on the situation, whatever the way that we are computing, we are always cross checking carefully whether we have received to this end or not. Otherwise, what will happen? The machine will hang. Okay? Now, to avoid such situation, and you know, sometimes when your computation, when we are looking into each time you are cross checking and you wanted to go back and forth this way, you may get better flexibility and constructing Turing machine very easily, you know, by taking a tape which is both sides infinite. That is what is essentially the feature of two-way infinite tape Turing machine, because here the tape, we may assume that I do not have any worry that I have to just verify whether I am reaching to the left end. Okay. I can simply look at the computation as long as I am having you know, I wanted to cross check something without worrying, I will simply keep on moving to left. There is no question of hanging. Okay. Such a feature, when we are including such Turing machine, you know, we may call that as two-way infinite type Turing machine, and depending on your sort of like configurations and those things when we are defining, we are not worried to look at this. So, where you are starting, you may sell them that as 0, 1, 2, 3, etcetera, and you can put some negative, say minus 1, minus 2, cell numbering you can make appropriately, whatever that we wanted. Okay? So, this is what so called this two-way infinite tape Turing machine, and it is all working nature is almost same. Here only worry you do not have to worry about what is going to happen when during a computation, whether this will hang or not, that kind of care you need not worry. You can formally define it, because if you look at the standard Turing machine, when we have defined m is equal to, we have written q sigma delta q naught quadruple state set, sigma input alphabet, delta the transitions, you know, and this q naught. Of course, sigma has a special symbol blank. Here also you can consider the same thing, okay? And the transitions are also the same. Only thing is, when you are talking about the computation, you know, you can have better facilities. Okay? exactly like a standard Turing machine you can give, but that is all. But when we come to the second one, the K-tape Turing machine, what is this, how it will be? This will be like, you know, you will have, I can write this K-tape separately, or I can put it like a grid, whatever you want. Okay, let me put for the time being separately. So, say some, if I consider two tapes or three tapes, whatever, like this, I may put. And here, the finite control, again only one control you will have, because for one Turing machine you have only one control, it is not that corresponding to each tape. But here you will put, you know, you will have heads like this connecting to each of this tape, you will have k heads. So, reading and writing head, the finite control is essentially one only, and the states you will have in this, the internal states, one set of states only. But what is the working nature? We can fix some convention, you know, I can always take the input on the first tape, and if I have to give some output, if it is, you know, for the purpose of Turing computable function, if it is computing a function, you require an output, I can expect always an output on the same first tape. And now, what is the use of other tapes? The other tapes can be used for some rough work, essentially. You know, depending on the type of problem that we are considering, the other tapes can be considered for that purpose, and will work on this K-tape Turing machine likewise. And you see, for certain examples, you can have very nice facility when you are doing some multiplication or whatever, a certain amount of information if you wanted to keep. Here, what we use it to do? We use it to go till right end, and we keep using those cells and making all that this thing. For example, if you wanted to have some multiplication, you do not have to worry to once again come back here and copy, come back and copy, that is what we have discussed. Now, what you can do, see, for example, if you are given two numbers in unary format, let me take that on the first step, say for example, I power n, say blank I power m, say two numbers when you are given, so you are starting here. What you can first do is, this one of the numbers that you will copy into this tape, right? Say for example, I power m I have copied here. Now, what I can simply do, even I power n, if you want to copy to another tape, so you copy that. Okay? Now, this candidate, when you are reading from one side to another, you can simply type on the first tape I power m once, then you can mark simultaneously here. Once again, you, when you are reading this simultaneously, you can type once again I power m. So, second I you can cross here, and I power m. Likewise, say for example, if you have number 3 here, 3 times this I power m can be copied very quickly. So, you see, the complexity will reduce, because earlier what we are doing, you have only one tape, you have to go back and forth to see that this number of i's are to be copied, and how many times this number of i's, say for example, I power m is getting copied, how many times that you have to copy, you have to check. So, that means several times you have to go back and forth and see like whether this many times I have copied it or not. But now, what you do, you simply, you can simultaneously do, because you have various heads here. Similarly, there are many other examples that very important one, you know, with respect to universal language, we will be constructing a universal Turing machine, that is a 3-tape Turing machine. That is a very good example, and you see, by giving such a facility, you can in fact construct very nice simpler Turing machines, which looks very simple, the simulations that you can show very easily. So, such Turing machine can be constructed with the extended feature. Now, how to define this formally? So, here again internal states, you can have the same this thing, like one set, and input alphabet, again the same thing. Now, the transition map delta and q naught, how should be this transition map? Because this transition map is from states. Earlier, what we were writing in case of standard Turing machine, the transition map is q cross sigma to, you know, you can have halting state also. And then, when we are looking at, either you can print a symbol or move left or right. That is what is the standard Turing machine we are writing. But here you see, what is the input? Input can be from the first step, the input to the Turing machine we are always keeping it in the first step. But in a transition, you will be reading this simultaneously, you can read what is here, simultaneously you can read what is here. That means, here this sigma, you can take k copies of this, because in all the on all the tapes, what is the information that you have that you will read, and then you will change the state, right. So, this is to q union this, the halting state, you may get halting state, and then what is here? In each of these step, either you know you can put some symbol, you can print some symbol, and another tape simultaneously you can move maybe right, or in another tape you can move to left. So, that means, whatever that we have here sigma union L R. So, this candidate in each tape individually you can do whatever that you want. That means, this k I am putting, this is k times, and each of this is corresponding to one of these tapes. So, we can formally define a k tape Turing machine this way. Okay. And there is another variant I have not listed there, let me put that, you know, k hat Turing machine. K hat Turing machine. How this k hat Turing machine? Because you will be having one tape, but you can put k number of heads on this tape. Like standard Turing machine, I may have one tape here. Always finite control is only one, internal states you have certain states here, okay, this is pointing. Here you can have some heads simultaneously. You see, these are all virtual machines, right. This kind of machine you do not have in your laboratory, you will essentially a simulator this one. Now, you do not have any problem that you know whether one head will go on the other head, will get jammed, this kind of situation will not occur. Okay. So, there is no problem of that kind of thing. Now, by having this many heads, what kind of flexibility or what kind of extension, what kind of facility that you can have? You see, for example, if I wanted to look at the language, set of all those strings x is equal to set of all those strings palindromes, for example, x is equal to x power r. Whether a string is reversal of itself or not. Now, if you consider the input on this, okay, you given x to cross check, what do? One head you put it here, other head you can first move in the first place to this, okay, and then you just come from this side one cell, and from this side also you come to one cell, and see in the internal memory you just cross check whether these two symbols are same or not. Otherwise, what we were doing, you are going till this end of the tape and reading the symbol, and then you are moving till end of the other side and cross checking by storing this in the internal memory through some state, and then you are cross checking whether these two symbols are same or not. You see the complexity, you have to go back and forth on the entire tape twice, you have to go to that end and come back to this end to cross check whether these two symbols, you know, that is what in every loop that we are doing. Now, if you have two, you know, if you have k heads, now I can choose two heads k equal to 2, and then simultaneously I will be able to cross check and see that this can be easily pursued. Similarly, it is a multiplication also, when I do not require even that many tapes, if I am allowed this many heads, like in the previous example what I did, we have copied those the input number m and n on different tapes or whatever, and then we have generated I power m n, we can generate I power m n on the first tape as output. Okay. So, but here what we do, if you have for example, say 3 heads, if I consider, one is tracking this I power n, other can track I power m, and then other head can take care of the printing part. So, that way this kind of extension will be helpful in giving a Turing machine very quickly. Okay. So, now you can try formally defining such a Turing machine, k head Turing machine, the way that I have mentioned for k tape Turing machine. Now, you can try formally defining k head Turing machine. Now, what is 2-dimensional Turing machine? So, here the situation is like, you know, in our argand plane first quadrant, you know, a grid of tapes. All the sites, you know, this is an infinite tape, you can think like this, the cells. Okay. And now, you may start, you will have one head to this. Now, you have a possibility of moving this head to up, left, right, down. So, this kind of features will be given. Now, the input, you may fix that, I will be taping, taking the input on this first grid, this sort of tape. And then you will be using this entire grid here, all the sides you have infinite, because this is left justified of course, and of course, this is bottom justified. Now, the grids, you see the cells, this is something like in your first quadrant, argon, first quadrant of the argon plane, you know, we are marking the cells, it will look like this. And in this two dimensional Turing machine, I have this is what two dimensional Turing machine, you can now use these cells, and appropriately you can use these cells for the memory, and the computation can be reduced. Okay. So, this kind of two dimensional Turing machine is another variant, you can also give a formal definition of this. This kind of variant. Okay. Now, let us come to the last variant that I have listed here, non-deterministic. You see, this non-determinism is already familiar with you in the context of finite automata, right, pushdown automata. So, non-determinism is essentially, in case of deterministic Turing machine, once again let me write this, this is delta q cross sigma, that means, given a state and a symbol, what we are doing, we are giving a state including a halting state, or a print or move the head to left or right, that is how we are having this assignment. But here, what do we do? This will be like, you know, the standard tape only, here we do not have any change of that, but only thing is that the simulation, that computation, we will consider non-determinism here. That means, if you write here m equal to q sigma, let me put this delta, the big one, q naught. Now, what is this delta? This delta, given a state and a symbol, in determinism, what we are doing? We are giving a next state and something we are doing corresponding to that state. Here, we give finitely many possibilities. That means, this delta will become a relation, it is a finite subset of q cross sigma, okay, cross, you know, you can give a next state, one among the halting states, or this cross that sigma union L r. When I am writing like this, you see, given a state and a symbol, now I can assign once, you know, this corresponding to say q a, for example, I can choose some p, and I can say, for example, print some b, that is one possibility I can give. Okay? This is a relation. And then, for q a, I can also give say some p prime and ask it to go to left, and for q a, I can also take some p double prime and I can ask it to go to r. I can also, okay, so q a, I can take say some p triple prime and I can print some other symbol. So, you can give various possibilities among this. So, that means, here I am considering this as a subset of this, that means, a relation, right. So, the non-determinism can be given as a relation, and in that is only a difference, but of course, which makes a lot of difference. That means, non-deterministically, you can choose one of the possibilities that you are going to assign among the possibilities given to a particular situation, that q a. Okay? This is what is non-determinism. Now, you see, the facility will automatically increase, right? I have explained in case of k-type Turing machine or two-way infinite type Turing machine. In non-determinism, you know already in case of finite automata how flexibility that you have, how quickly that you can give certain finite automata. So similarly, here also non-determinism will help you to give Turing machines for some of the languages very nicely, very quickly, very easily. Okay. Now, how does the computational power among these variants, among these extensions would that vary? Okay. If you look at that question, the answer is there is no difference in the computational power between the standard Turing machine and in any of these variants. You know, in case of finite automata, we have that situation. In case of finite automata, whatever the language accepted deterministic finite automata, it is same thing as the languages accepted by non-deterministic finite automata. They are essentially regular languages. Similarly, in case of Turing machines also, of course, Turing machines is not just as a language acceptor, we have this as a computational device. That means, you can have certain functions can be computed using Turing machines, right. Now, the same thing here, if you have a language accepted by standard Turing machine, that can be of course, accepted by any of these variants, because that can be easily covered in any of these variants, because these are extensions. And now, the converse, if you have a language accepted by any of these variants, can we have a standard Turing machine to accept that? The answer is yes. That means, as far as the language acceptance concerned, these are not something like, you know, you can have some bigger class of language accepted by this automata. Similarly, computable functions. Any function which can be computed using any of these variants can be sort of like done by and computed by a standard Turing machine. That means, as far as the computational power concerned, all these variants are equally, you know, they are no more powerful than standard Turing machine, or the standard Turing machine is equally powerful comparing to any of these variants. Okay. Now, what I will do, I will just give a way how do we look at for at least one or two cases that how we can really simulate the standard Turing machine with this kind of behavior, extended behavior. Okay. Let me start with maybe the two-way infinite type. Two-way infinite type Turing machine simulating a standard Turing machine. Okay. So, assume you are given a two-way infinite type Turing machine. That means, let me call that as say M 1 is say Q 1 sigma, you can call sigma 1, okay, delta 1 say the initial state here Q naught, does not matter. Okay. Now, this machine we can whatever this is doing, this two-way infinite type machine is doing, we will do it via a standard Turing machine. Let me write STM for standard Turing machine. How do we do that? This tape, I will write it formally little late, but let me, because there is nothing like, you know, tape width is fixed, okay? Because this is the machines are not something physical, right. What do we do? Whatever the input given to you on two-way infinite type Turing machine, let me parallelly write this also. The given one is this, you have cells. So, the input once it is given to you like this a 1, a 2 and so on, say a n, this is how probably we are working and going back and forth and doing the computation on this. Here what do you do, that a 1, a 2, a n whatever is there, first I will change the input in the format that I can see two tracks on the standard tape except the first cell. In the first cell, I will print a dollar symbol and then I will make this tape, I will see this tape, making means I will see this tape into two tracks. So, that my input will be seen this way a 1, a 2, a 3 and so on a n, and all others are just blanks. Now, you see what is the meaning of this, because whatever that tape content that I have, I am now dividing it into the two tracks. That means, what I will do when I am to do this, the tape is just one tape only, I will have one cell only here, but this cell content I will now fill with a pair, that A1 comma blank. This kind of pair I will type it here. Whenever the reading head is moving, it will read the entire cell content. It is not that, you know, reading head when it is moving, it will read only this portion and it will not be able to read, because we have the standard tape. Whenever the reading head is moving, you know, the reading head will read the entire this cell content. So, essentially what we are going to do is, whatever the symbol that you have and the two-way infinite tape Turing machine, now we are changing this cell information that to A1 blank. Of course, what I have suggested is, in the standard tape, first when the input is given A1, A2, AN, you to make this kind of thing, what I have to do? I have to first shift the entire input to one cell, right? Or, you know, when you are considering with the blank here, you will put a dollar here, that is all. And therefore, A1, A2, AN, those are there only, right? And this A1, we are now changing it to the symbol A1 blank. This is, you treat it as a new symbol, you may call it as B1. What is B1 symbol? That is A1 blank, a pair. Similarly, whatever that A2 is, the cell content that you have, that you, I will print it as A2 blank. Likewise, you know, what are the input we have, that input now is transformed to pair, so that I can see it is a two track. Now, once I have converted this to this kind of situation, what are the simulation that this guy is doing here on two-way infinite tape Turing machine, we will simulate that this here parallelly. How do we do that? When we are taking a left move on this, when you are coming to AN, okay, I will also come to the left, take the left move of that head, but what I have to look at here, you know, I will concentrate on this input, okay, but I will be reading the entire thing, I will be concentrating on this. If it keep on coming to this, I can always take the left move, the left move on the first track to read the first component, because I will be sort of like looking into or changing whatever that we are doing on the first step. If I take a left move, I will take a left move from here. So, let me call this is cell 0, this is cell 1, cell 2 likewise, and then I will call this a cell minus 1, cell minus 2, cell minus 3 likewise. So, what do I have here? 1, let me call this as 0, 2, 3 and so on. This will be minus 1, minus 2 likewise. What I will do, as long as I am in this positive numbered cells on the two-way infinite tape, if I am going left here, I will also go on this standard Turing machine left here. If I am going right on the two-way infinite machine, I will also go on the right on this. Okay? Now, if I reach to this 0 thing, I will come to this dollar. Now, from dollar, I have to use the option of changing track. That means, when I am in the two-way infinite tape machine, if the reading head comes to this 0 cell, from this cell, if it is going to right, that means, on the positive numbered cell, then I have to go on the upper track. If it is going left, then I will now consider the lower track. That means, now I will concentrate on reading on the cells which are on the lower track, or changing the cells here if it is a printing step. If it is going, for example, from here, if it is going to left, okay, if it is L, then what I have to do on this step, I have to go right, there is no left, because it will get hanged. So, I have to go right. And on this cell, if it is going to right, say for example, when you reach to this position, if it is going to right, then what I have to do? Because if you are going to right, then I have to go to left, because when I am coming to, say for example, minus 5, the cell minus 5, that means somewhere I am here, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. When it is going to right, on this lower tape, I have to read the symbols which are on the left side of this, therefore, I have to come to left. Okay? This kind of simulation that we will have on standard tape, so that whatever this exactly the two-way infinite tape machine is doing, exactly the same thing can be simulated on this standard machine. Okay? So, now let me give you a formal way of representing this. Let M1 equal to say Q1 sigma say delta, let me call it as Q, does not matter, because I am writing M1, M Q naught two-way infinite machine, two-way infinite tape machine that you have. I may write m prime here. I require states. The states now, so let me write it as q prime. What should be this? Because here the states essentially look for, the states have to consider all the things, you know, the state should be able to distinguish what is there on the left and what is there on the upper track, what is there on the lower track, right. So, states now we will divide with this, this q prime, q cross 1 comma 2. By this, what I am going to get in this? This q union sigma also, sorry, halting state also, because in the upper track if I am getting halting state, that will also should also be covered. Okay. This states cross 1 comma 2 in the sense that we are going to have whatever the simulations here. Of course, the halting state will come otherwise in this, and sigma. Now, you see what do I require in case of sigma? Sigma we require dollar a new symbol which is not there earlier, union the original symbols of sigma that you require, union, you know, the symbols which you should be able to accommodate on the both the tracks, that means sigma cross sigma, this also you would require. And then I take some special symbols which will record the halting, that means let me call it a sigma bar. If it is halting on the lower track, I will record through this union sigma bar cross sigma. I will tell you what is the sigma bar. The sigma bar, I mean you will just consider what are the symbols of sigma with a different representation, that is all, for each a belongs to sigma. How do I use this? See, for example, you know, when I am having, say for example, a here blank, and if the machine is halting at this kind of situation, that means on the first step, if I am having a, what I will now look at is this kind of situation, because I have h 1, this is the current. When it is halting, that we will make it h 1, so that we will understand that this is on the first step it is getting halted. And then this symbol in the tape symbol also we have to look into, because this is not a halting state now, because h 1 we will not consider a halting state, because for each Turing machine h is the halting state. So, when I have h 1, this tape content, you know, where finally it is halting, when I convert it back to a, I should be able to distinguish. So, for that matter, what we are writing, this is a bar will be the symbol that we will be considering. So, just to distinguish wherever exactly it is halting, you know, we make these special symbols. Okay. So, this is what is now the alphabet that we consider, and now let me write delta prime that I will explain to you, and then the initial state that we consider as it is. Okay. So, where you are starting? You are starting in the first step. So, you can declare that to be the initial state. Okay. So, you will be starting there. Now, the simulation part. The simulation part is now first what we have to do, you have to change the tape into this and tracks, that printing you should be able to have. And now, this delta prime, how it works? If you have this q 1 that is on the first step, whatever the input that you have a 1 a 2, that means you are on the first step, we will change it to the state p 1 left, if you know. So, this I am writing in connection to, in case of two way tape machine, whatever is there, that means if the original this thing, assume delta of q comma a 1 is equal to say p comma b, then if B is equal to L, then we take L, and this is P 2, we will take in case of this is in the first step. So, if it is going to if B is R, we take going to right. Now, with this phenomena, I will explain you like how formally we can design a standard Turing machine corresponding to a given two-way infinite type Turing machine. So, if you are given two-way infinite type Turing machine Q sigma delta Q naught, we will consider you know this M prime, some Q prime, sigma prime, delta prime, and this. The states here we consider corresponding to you know the states of this, which are which can be manipulated on the on both the tapes on both the tracks, and this sigma prime is essentially looking at this special symbol and the elements of this. So, to accommodate the symbols a space like both upper track and lower track, and then some more symbols that we include that I will explain you to look at this sigma that sigma bar I am writing. Okay. So, tapes on the first, the first component is on the first track, second component on the second track, the sigma bar cross sigma. Now, what is this sigma bar? The sigma bar is essentially taking the symbols of sigma, we just denote A bar. The purpose of this is whenever the machine is halting, I have the state on the when we are in the first track, I will have H 1. And when I am in the second track, I will have H comma 2, this kind of state I will halt. But the halting state of a Turing machine is essentially H, just when we are when we wanted to halt at the same place, I will record the symbol and then go to that particular place and make the halt. Okay? So, to make it, we will have this kind of special symbol sigma bar, which is one symbol each corresponding to each symbol of sigma. Okay? So, now how do we simulate it? The simulation portion is this, you take any transition in two way infinite machine that say q comma for example, A if it is p b. Now, depending on b and where you are depending on that, we will be doing this simulation. That means, this delta prime, if this state when we are considering on the first track, what do? We will now consider corresponding to this A and any symbol A, say for example, A prime, should I write A prime or maybe any symbol say some C on the lower track, what do? We will give that the P 1, the state P 1 moving to left, if this B is left. If B is right, of course, the change state is this on the first step, we will ask it to go to right. Okay? This is the pair we will assign. Now, for example, if B is an element of sigma, that means, if it is a printing step, the state which is getting changed is P 1. But now, on the first track only this change of symbol will take place, that means, B on the first track, on the second track there is no change, the same C will be there. Okay? Now, so corresponding to the transition in the two-way infinite type machine, in the standard machine we will give these transitions this way. And if this is in the lower track, if this information is in the lower track, that means, the current state Q and if the symbol is in the lower track, that means, this symbol is on the cell which is left to the 0, then what I will do, I will now give transitions for the lower track. That means, the state will be this Q2, and for any symbol on the upper track, that is C and A, we will give like this. If B is L, as I had mentioned, we should move in this track to right. Okay. If B is right, then in the lower track, that means the state component is 2, we have to move to left. And if it is an element of sigma, if it is an element of sigma, what I have to do in this, the first component, that is an upper track, there is no change, but here we are going to print B here. Okay? Is this definition clear? So, once again, if I have to explain, let me put 0 here, 1, 2, the cells like this, this, and on this, after we have converted this to, you know, 2 track, when I am reading A here on the first track, I will always have internal state corresponding to this Q here. Suppose I am reading the second cell in the state Q, this first the cell will be on this entire cell, of course, the reading head will be, but in the internal state, through internal state we will recognize that if I have the internal state Q1, I mean that I am reading the first track, I feel that I consider that I am reading the first track. If the internal state having the second component, say for example, if it is Q2, I consider the input that on the lower track, upper track and the lower track. Okay? That is what is the convention. Now, depending on what is happening in this two-way infinite tape machine, we will be updating this tape. So, as I had explained to you earlier, now if A is the symbol which is on the right side of the tape, that means the internal state if it is Q1, so the first component will get affected if it is printing step, or movement will be considered on the first track with respect to the first track, and the second track information will not change in the printing step. Okay? And now, what else we have to do? When I am coming to this dollar symbol, I have to look at that, you see, I have to change the track. That means, when I am coming to the dollar from the upper track, then I will change to the lower track and so on. So, that means, how do I consider that? Delta of this Q1, if I get dollar on the tape, then what I will say, this you change to the second track, that means the internal state will be represented by this, and ask it to go to right. Similarly, if delta of, if I am in Q2, if I am receiving dollar this thing, that means I from the second tape lower track I have come to this dollar, then you ask it to go to right. Okay? So, that means this Q1 R you ask, because whenever I am in dollar, the track change will be considered this way. Okay? And then now you look at the situation will be like this. You have made till this point the tracks. So, this 0, 1, 2 and so on, and till this point that you have considered minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and so on, you have made it this way, but thereafter you have cells like this only. That means, whenever you come to a blank cell, what to do? This blank cell, first now we make it into 2 blanks. That means, if it is on the upper track, that means, in any state Q in the upper track, that means, this is the internal state. If I am receiving a blank symbol, this delta prime, what we have to do in the first, we are in the first track the same state, but first we will convert this input to 2 blanks. That means, upper track blank, lower track blank. Similarly, this if you are in the lower track also, when I am reading the blank symbol, then you will continue to the same state, and you continue to the do the computation in the lower track, but you will first convert it into 2 blanks, so that the tape can be extended to 2 tracks. Okay? Say for example, if I am here, first I will not just see this way, I will now consider this like this. Okay? So, this is one, and now this head recording that that position, that halting position recording related to that, what do we do? If I am coming to the halting state when I am simulating on the upper track, so I have something A 1, A 2, what I will do? I will now convert it into this halt state, but this A 1 bar A 2. Okay? And similarly, this when I am halting that in the lower track, now you see this, for example, some input A 1, A 2, that will now, this is the head recording position, this halting state, that A 1, A 2 bar. So, to indicate that where exactly this is getting halt. Now, you see once it is coming to a halting position, I do not have to we do not have any possibility of continuing, right. Only thing is it is just recording the position. Okay? So, that you know if you wanted to record this position where exactly this is halting, so that will be shown up here with this symbol, okay, whether it is in the upper track or the lower track. For that matter only we are distinguishing these symbols. Okay? So, with this kind of construction, with this kind of simulation, what we can do, whatever the two-way infinite tape machine you are doing the job, that can be simulated on a standard machine as well. Okay? Similarly, by considering this kind of tracking business, that means what are the standard tape that you have, we have now converted the input as pairs. Now, if I make this as triplet, you know, that means say for example, for the symbol A at one, in one cell if you have, I can put in any symbol, any complex symbol I can put in one particular cell. Say for example, A1, A2, A3, I am putting it vertically, then I will see that I am dividing it into three tracks. So, this is not something like, you know, tape physically is getting changed, only the input on that we are changing, so that we can track the simulation, whatever that we want to, what kind of extension that we wanted to have. Now, the similar mechanism can be adopted to simulate the even other higher machines, higher versions, what are the extended versions. Say, for example, if you are looking for K-tape Turing machine. Okay? So, I have K tapes like this and I have K heads also, right? I have say various heads. What do you do in standard tape? Now, you divide this tape into first cell. This is one cell only, for just to write to accommodate this many lines, I am just writing it bigger. So, I will put this special symbol like this. The input is always, we will now make it into first track. And odd number track will be considered, will be seen as the tapes that you have here. Say for example, I have three tapes here, then I will divide this into six tracks, that means 1 and 2 for the first tape, 3 and 4 for the second, 5 and 6 for the third. What I will do here, why I am making this, because I have to record the head position also. So, the odd number track will contain the elements of sigma, this third one, fifth one. Now, what is in between ones, the even number ones, there I will print either 0 or 1 from here. If I have zeros here, that means the reading head is not present here, wherever the reading head is present, there I will put 1. That means, when I am reading, so I will convert first the input given to me onto the upper track, I mean the first track, and the remaining cells to start with there may be blanks, but the reading head wherever it is, there I will have 1 and other cells we have zeros. So, that is how we will first change the what is called the standard tape, and then we start simulating. And how do I simulate? See, for example, if I am doing some movement with the first head, then I have to consider that. So, where is the head? Head will be denoted by this symbol, say for example, 1. Now, first I will pursue this. Here I can do it simultaneously, first step I can simultaneously consider with this, second I can consider this simultaneously, third I can consider simultaneously. But here what I will do, first I will pursue 1, because I have only one reading head on this step, and then see, like I will transform this change, then I will pursue whatever has been pursued by the second head. So, by considering where exactly, you know, because there is only one head. Now, when I am working on the first step, I will now first look at the where is the head position, so that I will know where is the, what is the input that I have to pursue. When I am concentrating on the second head to pursue the matter, then I will now first look at on the fourth track, where is one, and then the particular input will be pursued. And when I am concentrating on the third one, then I will look at where is the current head and then pursue the concerning input. So, that means, what is happening here, whatever that simultaneously there I am doing, here I will do it sequentially, because I have only one head, but the when I am moving from one track to another, that means, if I am working with the first tape and then with the second tape, then I have to know where exactly the reading and writing head was. So, that is essentially denoted by this 0 ones. So, once I know that the reading head was left here, you just go to that position and do the appropriate changes, go back and forth. So, you may have to do so many steps. For example, for one step here, you may have to consider so many steps here, because you have to completely, you may have to come from a particular position of the head to the position to search for where exactly was the head for a corresponding track and to consider this simulation. So, this kind of extension can also be simulated. The K type Turing machine can also be simulated by a standard tape Turing machine, and see that there is no difference in the computational power. Of course, the complexity may vary, because whatever that you can do it easily in case of these higher variants, for standard machine you may have to put little more time, you may have to give more steps to do the job, right. So, the complexity may vary, but as far as the computational power concerned, they are all equivalent. Okay. So, that is about you know, some of the variants of this Turing machine, and regarding non-determinism, we will be studying little more in other lectures. Okay.